The Kenya Airports Authority has been such a major battleground for political interest that it has seen a managing director suspended, reappointed and finally sacked, as well as the exit of board members and a year-long search for a substantive MD that has seen more false starts than an Olympic sprint race.
Kenya Airports Authority.
Lucy Mbogwa left office under a cloud a year ago, and political interests have prevented the appointment of a substantive managing director to replace acting MD Yatich Kangugo.
This process was started, but it was soon thereafter cancelled because of various internal dynamics. The advertisement that was done by PwC was done both locally and internationally, spelling out very clearly what it is that you are looking for in that position.
On the 5th of July, six shortlisted candidates were subjected to interviews by the board at PwC's headquarters.
In the order of merit, Mr. Jonny Andersen, the Norwegian, scored a total score of 88%. Then that was followed by Mr. Joseph Kimote at 82%, Mr. James Muriuki Kibati at 74%, and Mr. Robert Mureithi Degwa at 73%, and Mr. Kirwa William Kipkemoi at 72%, and Mr. Yatich Kangugo at 63%.
Andersen is a career aviation executive with over two decades' experience in the management of airports in Norway, Denmark, and Latvia, and has taken the reins at the KAA at a tumultuous season. The Jomo Kenyatta International Airport is undergoing a raft of changes expected to boost its capacity and the quality of services. Terminals 1A and 1E are awaiting official commissioning, following a failure to launch last month owing to a last-minute cancellation. In March, KAA terminated the Greenfields Terminal project, a 56 billion shilling facility which was expected to add to the capacity of the JKIA by 20 million passengers per annum. So Andersen comes into office not only facing an overflowing in-tray, but also a taste of the hot seat that is the helm of Kenya's airport's managing institution. Alex Mwangi, NTV Business.